Hei, 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 alle sammen, og velkommen til det andre programmet i serien Magisk. Du så kanskje på forrige gang, du som ikke så på forrige gang, har vi kanskje med deg melding, sånn at vi vet hva du drev med. Her oppe i slottet mitt, det jo ikke helt godt kjent enda, for jeg har jo nett kjøpt det. Det masse rare irrganger, og jeg prøver å gjøre meg litt kjent. Og mens jeg gikk rundt her oppe på, oppe i steinrøse her, som jeg kaller det, så tenkte jeg på hva er det som gjør at noen blir tryllkunstnere, og andre ikke blir det. Sånn som jeg er jo på en måte selvlært, og jeg kan vise deg for eksempel en liten tryllkunst som jeg kan. Du tar et tau, så skal jeg lage noe som heter fjernsynsknuten. Kan lure på hvorfor den heter fjernsynsknuten, det ser jo ut. Ser tilsynelatende ut som en vanlig blåknute, men poenget er at den ser ut som et fjernsyn. Det er det som er det. Når det gjelder trollmenn da, og hvorfor folk blir trollmenn, så har det jo sånn som mange vil påstå at Kevin Keegan kanskje var en stor trollmann, eller Gunnar Berge eller Johs Harviken. Men at det skulle gå en rød tråd for samlebåndet på Ferrari-fabrikken og til magiens verden, det skulle kanskje ikke mange tro. Vi har nemlig som gjest en av verdens beste tryllekunstnere i dag, og han begynte med å skru sammen Ferrarier, så flyttet han til Amerika og ble verdensberømt og sånn. Og en annen gjorde akkurat det samme, bare mye, mye, mye lenger siden. Han heter Slaidini, han levde for lenge siden. Han kom også fra Italia til Amerika. Så kan jeg se på han litt mens jeg går og tenker meg om og ser meg omkring her i slottet mitt litt.
Nå må alle små speidere følge godt med, for jeg er sikker på at når gamle gode Slaidini var i speideren, så fikk han masse knutemerker til å sy på skjorta si. Følg med på knutene hans.
Det er skikkelig rent og fint, for nå på dette slottet da, så vil vi få den aller første utenlandske gjesten vår. Hele veien fra internasjonale magiske kretser og greier. Skikkelig stilig. Kom inn, kom inn, kom inn!
Oh, hi, how are you?
Aldo Colombini.
Nice meeting you.
It's an honor.
It's a wonderful place, wonderful place.
It's good to have people coming all the way from other countries.
Thank you, I'm very happy to be here.
It's very nice.
Very happy, wonderful place.
It's a beautiful castle.
Compliments to the decorator, yes,
really. Yes, it's not me, but I will take the compliment.
Yeah, I bet it's even nicer when it's finished. Anyway.
Thank you.
Yeah. Can I shake
you? Yeah, please.
I think it's...
Please, sit down.
Don't you have a maid here in this?
Maid? This is the 90s.
Oh, what a wonderful place, yes.
I have to clean myself, but it's clean here. You're not happy?
I'm very happy to be here. It's wonderful. Oh, the atmosphere is great here, yeah.
I like very much that you are from Italy.
Yes, originally from Italy, yes.
But you live in the Americas.
Yes, I moved there 2 years ago. And I'm still moving.
You're still moving?
Because of the earthquake, yeah. Every day there's very nice.
But you started working on the Ferrari factory?
Yes, Ferrari factories, yes.
Making Ferraris, how was that?
Assembling in the assembly line, I think you call it. Yeah. I was living in that small village in Italy, and everybody there works in the Ferrari factory.
Did you like it?
No. No, it was very boring, I thought to myself, I want to do something else, and then I tried to play guitar in a band.
Yeah, that's nice.
I liked it, like country music.
Country music?
Yes.
Italian country music?
No, American country music.
Okay.
American. And then I became a magician.
That's good.
Which is almost 25 years now.
And that's why you come here all the way to Norway, to the castle.
That's incredible. Nice. That's the real magic of magic.
It is.
Being here.
That's
Can
wonderful.
I show you something?
Oh, yeah, if you want to, please.
No, I have here a special thing for you.
Okay, that's great.
And actually for all the people watching, hopefully. And these are special cards.
Okay.
Not a lot of magicians tell that they use special cards.
No, they say they use only regular cards.
No, I can use a special card. They are specially chemically treated cards. They have a special liquid on these cards.
Okay.
Yes, on both sides. And then you'll see what happened with this special liquid on both sides that we have. Also, would you like to keep this card, please?
Yeah, det er et helt kvitt kort. Det er ingenting på det, som vi sier I Norge.
I couldn't have said it better.
No.
and also I have an ordinary deck of cards.
This is an ordinary.
Yeah, ordinary. I give you my word of honor as a magician.
Okay.
and I'm going to do this very, very simple. And anytime you want, you say stop.
How do you say stop in Italian?
Stop.
Stop.
Here, put your card there on top.
Okay.
Now, remember, every one of these cards has been treated with a special liquid. Mm. Per se, alone, the liquid doesn't do anything. But if you put the ink of a card, let's say you just place the card, or a 10 of spades that you have selected. If you put a 10 of spades, the ink of these 10 of spades with the special liquid on the other card, look, I'm going to print a card. But it's, of course, it's a mirror image of this card, you see, because if you put the card like this, it's a mirror image. And with a mirror image card, you can print a regular card, you see. You print a regular card.
Nå det altså omvendt, og så det ordentlig igjen, altså speilvendt og vanlig. Speilvendt, vet du?
Yeah, or you can do even better. Look, you can print a face like this, and you can print a back together. So you have a, how do you call it, double exposure or whatever, something like this. But you must be very careful with these cards.
I understand, very careful. Yes.
For example, if you print the card like this, and you touch the ink while the ink is still wet, you have, it's not very, I mean,
you can't play with a card like this.
No, you can play with a card like this. And practically you can print anything you want. For example, you can print just a piece of the card, you see. And you can print, for example, you can print the card, and while the ink is still wet, you spin the card like this, and you have this special effect with this.
Oh,
you see with
that's
that.
Nice.
Yeah, thank you. Oh, even better. Look, even better. You can print the card like this, and before the ink get dry, look, all the pips go on the bottom like this. You can print anything you want practically with this card. For example, you take this card and you move the cards on. All the peeps and all the number. That's all.
That's wonderful.
Thank you. Thank you. It's better than working at a Ferrari, believe me.
It's much better, and this is more like, maybe you could use it in money, printing.
I've tried. I have tried.
But you're still out? You're not in jail?
Yes, I have a trial in Italy in a couple of years. No, I'm just kidding. No, I don't do it. It is a pleasure. Doing money is against the law.
I think while we're sitting here having it cozy, we'll have a look at another magician who is doing a very special trick, and that's for, og det kan jeg jo si på norsk. Nå skal vi få se et filmklipp, sånn som vi pleier å få se her I Magisk, av en annen magiker, og så kommer Aldo og jeg tilbake etterpå. Ha det trivelig så lenge. It's amazing that you could... har Legio, han driver på med duer, og jeg ikke spesielt noe spesielt glad i duer. Altså, jeg, hvis det opp til meg, så har vi tatt 50, for eksempel 50 tryllekunstnere, i sånne Reinholdsverksuniformer, inn og så rydder hele byen for duer. Why do the magicians do the pigeons all the time? Use pigeons?
Good question. I think probably because they are very easy to carry around, to take around. I mean, traveling with animals is not very easy.
No.
I mean, with fishes or dogs or tigers, I mean. And besides, I think that the pigeons are very puffy. They look big, but they are not that big.
So
we couldn't say these things. In,
no, we'll probably take it away.
No, you can leave. You can leave.
But
and besides, it's nice to see them because they work. It means that they work with pigeons. Otherwise, usually they ate them. If they don't work, they ate the animal.
And they shit on statues.
They shit on statues.
So I couldn't have them in my castle. You're glad there is no pigeon in your room?
They shit on statues because, I mean, it's nice to have their opinions in that way. on some stature. Oh, by the way, I have to apologize with you.
Okay.
Because I was up in the room and I pulled the cord to call the maid and I broke it.
Mm. You broke the rope?
Yeah, I'm sorry. But I can do something for this.
Okay, that's
this.
Nice. That's
I can do a trick.
A plaster
magic trick.
Magic trick, that's
can
okay.
Can I?
Please, Aldo.
you called me for this, I mean. Well, I was going to tell you the story of the 40 thieves, but maybe you're not interested in politics.
Very Italian funny, very. Joke.
So I'm going to do a rope trick. The reason why I call it a rope trick is because I use a rope.
Mm-hmm.
Very funny.
Yes.
A lot of people tie knots to remember. For example, my wife has a terrible memory. She remembers everything. they said that too much sex can cause memory loss. What was I about to do?
Okay,
if I cut off the knot like this, we have two pieces of ropes, more or less the same length. But just by saying the Italian magic words, mamma mia, please say.
Mamma mia. Mamma mia!
That's good, that's
mamma
good.
Mia.
The rope is fully restored. Okay, no, never mind. Would you like to blow on the... Thank you very much.
It's fully restored.
Thank you. Now, you must have immediately exactly in the center and two. Wait a moment. Four ends. I have done this trick dozens of times and always towards are like this. Oh, four ends and 2 meters. Four ends and 2 meters means two ropes.
Two,
much better. Like this. let's start over again. Get confused when I do this. One of the most incredible stunts in magic is the cut and restored rope. Usually you cut the rope in the middle and then you restore it.
Mm.
Where did I put the scissors? I'm sorry for this. Never mind. We do this. Look.
Yeah.
Okay, that's scaring. Two ropes. It takes two ropes to make this trick and it takes also two persons to make a marriage. A girl and their mother. Okay.
I like your Italian joke.
Wait a moment, I am confused. Let's start over again. Get confused about this. Would you like to be so kind to tie the two ropes together, please?
Yes.
And while you are busy tying the ropes together... sorry for this. Karate. Ah! That's it. It takes three ropes to make the next trick. Yes, look. Okay. One small, one rope a little bit longer... and one long, and one very, very long. Do you know what you get if you cross an elephant with a kangaroo?
No.
Big holes all over Australia. I love this joke. But if you cross a small, a medium, and a long rope, you will have three pieces of ropes exactly the same length. I know. Hold your applause. Oh, you are. No, never
I'm
mind.
Not
oh, no, it's okay. Magicians has two ways to make knots disappear. One is invisible and the other one is visible. I show you both. Maybe. Souvenir.
Nice.
Souvenir. Put them under your pillow and tomorrow you will have a tooth. Look. One, two, and three. With my shoes off, I can count to 20. One knot will vanish invisibly and the other knot will leave the rope visibly. Okay? This will leave the rope invisibly. Look. And this will leave the rope visibly. But this is not an ordinary knot, it's a special knot, believe you or not. and it goes back on the rope. And if I take a gun out of my pocket...
A gun?
A gun. Look.
Okay.
Buffalo Bill's last stand. Bang! 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 Bang!
That's for
you.
Guys.
And you may put it back on your room. I'm sorry for this. I'm happy I restored the rope and
you
everything.
You made up for everything. This made up for everything that you did to the rope in the room.
Yeah.
This was amazing.
Thank you. Thank you. I hope you like, and I hope they like too.
I don't know if you're interested, but as a service to you for being so good at me, maybe you see the little beeper, the little blinker.
Oh, yes, this is quite interesting.
This goes down to a very special person who lives down in the basement.
Oh, I've been told about this man.
He's
Max.
Max?
He's a very, very, very weird guy. I mean, it's strange. I have to go down there,
but maybe if you want to go instead of me?
No. I've been told it's cold over there. It's dark. I'm afraid of the dark. 5,000 lira? No, it's not even $5,000. No, I don't want to... I respect Max,
but
down there is very bad. I mean, I've been told this for...
If I don't come back...
I wish you all the best.
If I come
back... Say hello to Max.
I will. If I come back, we'll see you later.
He has a lot of guts.
Max! Se ilden lyse. Så var det ned igjen I denne grotto her da. Hello, Max.
Ah, hello, Arne. How are you?
Good to see you again.
Well, speaking of seeing, I've been doing some experiments with perception. You see, one of the things that's very obvious about this series is that sometimes things are not what they appear to be.
That's the nature of that. Det på mange måter då kärnan I all magi, the nature of magic, life.
Life itself, I think.
Life itself.
Well, here's an example. This is a picture. I'll show you this for a moment. What is it a picture of?
It's a picture of a skull.
A skull?
And skull.
You are correct. You are correct. It is a picture of a skull. But if you look more closely, you will see that it is really a picture of a woman sitting at a dressing table looking at herself in the mirror.
Här ser det alltså att det är en dama som faktiskt skulle sitta och se sig själv I spegeln. Ja. I didn't see that.
You see? So things are not always what you may think, you see.
That is very true.
Yes, so we're going to leave this picture here to remind us about that as we continue with an experiment using a deck of cards.
Kortstokker, that's
I'm
often
sure you
used.
Know how to play cards.
Yeah.
Perhaps you play some gambling games sometimes.
I play some poker with my friends from time to time.
So. Well, yes?
I just want to say that I only play with the fake money. Also, I spell it in my ekta penger.
Oh, well, if we ever play it, we'll be with real money, I can assure you.
Don't tell anyone.
But oops, stay there.
Don't tell anyone.
I will ask you to cut about half the cards.
Deler vi stokken I to.
Okay, and you have cut to the five of clubs. If you cut one more card deep, it would be a different one. They are all different, as you can see. But you picked the five of clubs. And that's very important.
Yeah.
Because if we look even more carefully into this picture, you will see that the woman in the picture is holding something in her hand. And what she has in her hand is a playing card. And that playing card is...
It's the five of clubs.
It's the five of clubs, which is of course exactly the one that you have taken.
Jeg delte altså denne stokken I, jeg delte stokken I to biter, helt tilfeldig. Og så ser jeg at inni dette bildet så har damen som sitter der faktisk kløver fem.
Well, now I think I have made my point. I think you have learned a very valuable lesson. And you must think about this for a while I go off and put this back in the gallery.
Han litt av en luring, denne Max, og nok en gang så ble jeg lurt. Han kommer jo ned her I denne kalde, guffende grotta hans, og stadig så blir jeg like lurt. Jeg håper det og ble litt lurt der hjemme I Stovo. Vi skal litt ut I naturen, holdt det på seg. Det jo sånn at magi og illusioner også kan skje ute. Og vår venn Wayne Dobson har faktisk tenkt å få litt ting som ute der til å forsvinne, kanskje. Så følg med.
Well, here I am at Woolerton Park in Nottinghamshire, while I'm surrounded by this completely open space. Have you ever been wandering through the park, really enjoying yourself, gathering together your thoughts, when somebody spoils it by turning the radio on? The football game develops. You think to yourself, wouldn't it be great if I could get rid of these guys? Well, Between you, me and the gay post, that's exactly what I'm going to do. Because these guys know they're going to take part in an illusion, but they don't know I'm going to make them disappear. You see, what I'm going to do is place them inside this very large canvas tent. Once inside this canvas tent, what will happen is the sides will be brought up. All right, once the sides are brought up, you will notice that you can see completely all around and all above this canvas tent. So there's nowhere and no place for these people to go. I promise you. But can you imagine if you just snapped your fingers, the music stopped, and everybody completely disappeared? But that's just not possible. Or is it a kind of magic? Good night.
Oh.
Mamma mia, macabre, macabre situation, fiasco.
I told you, don't go down, it's dangerous down there with Max.
He fools me all the time. I've been twice down there and he I don't understand anything. Mamma mia.
It's great, no, it's great. But it's dangerous down there. I told you, I don't want to go, I don't want to come there. Oh, by the way, I was here doing something, thinking something about my next trick.
Yeah.
A balloon.
Hey,
How do you say this in...
Ballon. In Italian?
Pallone.
Pallone.
Close enough.
Pallone.
Ah. Okay. Would you like to keep it just for a moment?
Of course. Right? I love balloons.
Thank you
Ballone.
Very much.
Pallone.
Now, some cards.
Yes?
Look, I hate to do this, but I do it so well. Okay, never mind. I'm going to deal the cards from hand to hand, and please say stop. Anytime you want, you may say stop.
Okay.
Here?
Yeah.
Please take the card. Don't show it yet to the camera, please.
No.
Because I want to show you one thing. The card one moment before would have been this card. The card after your would have been this card. The top card would have been that one. Would you like to show the card to all your friends through the camera? I don't want to see. I don't want to look. I don't want to look. I've seen this trick before. Nothing here. Nothing here. Nothing here.
Right.
Just kidding. I put the deck into the case like this,
yeah.
Card box. Would you like to stick the card in the middle of the deck?
Okay.
Like this.
Okay.
Okay. No, I didn't say to square it. I lost it now. Just kidding. Okay.
Okay.
The balloon?
Yeah.
And the card. You push the card in the middle of the deck.
Of course.
And this is the card case and this is the balloon.
Yep.
We just blow up the balloon one moment before.
Yeah.
Look, I'm going to take this, just a pin, and I'm going to pop up the balloons, and two things will happen. All the spectators at home will have a sudden awakening. and the card will appear where the balloon was, or in the middle of the balloon. Tell me the name of your card.
It was a Seven of Clubs.
Seven of Clubs, look.
Mine damer og herrer, det helt utrolig, altså, hvordan får du det til?
Exactly.
Hæ?
Exactly.
Jeg skjønner ingenting, jeg.
I have no idea what you said, but I agree with you.
Du kan få komme igjen her, you can come back. You can stay in the castle.
Really?
You can stay.
Thank you very much.
Vi tilbake neste veke med en ny kar, sånn som denne kjekke bamsen fra Italia. Filmen magisk, det her det skjer. It's very nice.
Thank you for selecting the right car.
You can stay. I will tell the... Thank you.